Hello, my name is Tyler. I'm just currently editing the podcast that you are about to watch. Unfortunately, and I do apologize for this, there are a couple instances where the podcast isn't in the best quality. About halfway through the podcast, my battery in my camera ran out, so I had to switch it out. And I guess in the process of doing that, I was really frazzled. When I came back, you know, my angle was a little bit out of focus. And then the audio from the second camera isn't the best. Luckily, most of the audio is from my camera, and it's pretty good audio. So there's a couple little things like that, some focusing errors that we'll fix for the next time. But you know, this is the first time we're doing this. This is the first time Flickr's done something like this. This is the first time I think a podcast on Hawkstream has been recorded, to my knowledge, like this. With a two-camera setup to be posted on YouTube. So I'm just sitting here editing it. I noticed that, I want to let you guys know. So anyway, I do hope you enjoy it though. Put it on the background as you're studying, something like that. And I say in the podcast, but all the information we talk about will be found in the description down below. Links to all the trailers, the news stories, everything we talk about. So be sure to check all that out. And I'm gonna get back to working on this. It's a lot, it's about an hour and a half. So. Thank you, and I hope you enjoy.
Click it. Huh?
We're not live.
We're not live? We're live?
Yes, we're live.
We're live?
We're live. You can say that we're live as many times as you want.
Holy cannolis! Hello!
Hello.
Hello, everybody.
Hey.
Hello. All right. My name is Tyler Ferraro. Welcome to the first ever official Flickr Film Podcast. This is going to be a podcast that we do every once in a while. If you miss it tonight, don't worry. We're also recording, and this will go up on Friday after we post this. So, you know, if you're tuning in now, maybe you got to tune out later. Be sure to check out the Flickr YouTube on Friday. Mm-hmm. Say hello to the cameras. Hello, cameras.
Hello, cameras.
Hello, cameras.
Hello.
All right, so again, I'm Tyler Ferraro, and I am here with
Noah Campagna,
Felix Carlson,
Brian Hubscher.
That's all four of us. And Shout out to Cody Cannon, who's working the cameras, making sure that we're constantly recording at all times.
He's working the cannons.
Cody Cannon's working the cannons.
Misspelled my name.
his name's got two N's in it. Cool. So let's kind of just go around and kind of introduce ourselves. This is the first time we're doing this. We'll start with you, Noah. What's up with you?
Noah Campagna.
Yeah, what's up with your situation?
My situation?
Yeah, what's your situation? Like Mike.
Like Mike?
Yeah. Like Mike, the situation. So we're talking about.
Oh, Mike, the situation.
Yeah,
that's good.
Okay, cool.
Yeah,
you're good. What's your affiliation with Flickr? What do you do?
I'm the event coordinator with Flickr, and I coordinate the events.
You can lean in a bit. You know,
cool.
You
can just get him close.
There you go. There's that voice I love.
Thank you.
Cool. Felix, what's up with you?
Hello. I'm doing well. You know, my name is Felix Carlson. I'm a freshman, new to Flickr. You know, I'm a long-time filmmaker, first-time Flickr,
sounds about right, yeah.
Producer, cinematographer on the new film, okay, plug, okay, there we go, I'm done.
Cool. Brian?
Hi, I'm Brian Hubscher. I am the technical director for Hawkstream.org. I also have a show called The Corner, super plug, at Tuesdays at 5, and I'm just a super fan of the Flickr Film Club.
Awesome. Also, he's not on a mic, but shout out to Cody Cannon. He also has a show. When's your show, Cody?
Thursdays at 6:30.
He has a show. So check out Hawkstream Thursdays at 6:30 for that show. And then when's your show? Tuesdays at 5 for Brian's show, The Corner.
Woohoo!
All right, guys. Well, this is a we're all film people, so let's get right into some films and stuff. We are film people. My mom just texted me the audio sounds good, so let's get ready to rock and roll.
Nice.
How's the cameras looking, Cody? Fantastic. All right. So,
this summer,
there was a summer season that was had, and a bunch of movies came out. Let's just go over a couple of these movies. What movies did you guys see? What was your favorite? What was your least favorite? Let's go.
So many. Okay, so let's see. We have Jurassic World, Fury Road, Straight Outta Compton, Avengers 2, Slow West, Perfect 2, Tomorrowland, Inside Out, The Man from Uncle.
Man, oh man.
That was from heaven.
I saw my uncle or something.
Really? Oh man.
Where'd you go to see your uncle?
He was down the street.
Oh, he lives down the street?
Yeah.
Okay.
He's the uncle man.
Oh, so you got out of the house?
Yeah, I got out of the house.
Alright, cool. What was your least favorite? What was your least favorite movie over the summer?
Fantastic Four.
Yeah, Fantastic Four.
I'm so sorry you had to see that.
I'd probably have to go with Insidious 3. The worst part was probably that that was the first Insidious I'd seen. The second worst part was just the movie. I'm gonna get flack for this one.
My dear girlfriend just texted me, tell Nick and Felix to get closer to the mic. Other than that, the audio sounds good.
Sorry, turn them up a little bit.
There you go. Fantastic.
We're turning it up.
I'm gonna get flagged for this one. I think my least favorite movie over the summer was Inside Out.
Really?
Yeah.
I mean, I haven't seen it yet. I kind of want to. So we'll see.
It made me feel so many things.
Yeah, like it was like good, but I did not. The whole plot just hinged on sadness being just dumb.
Yeah.
Like, if sadness followed the rules like everyone else did, there would be no movie. So sadness just screwed the whole thing up.
That's the point.
Well, I feel like most of our favorite movies hinge on really stupid things happening.
Yeah, but like...
Like, one of the best films of the summer, Jurassic World, hinges on them trying to continually make dinosaurs, even though every time they do, it's a bad idea. Like, I feel like after Jurassic Park 1, there shouldn't be a need for 2, 3, and 4, because you should have learned your lesson. Dinosaurs are not supposed to be, you know...
Well, technically Jurassic World takes place directly after Jurassic Park 1. It disregards the second and third ones. They're no longer canon in Jurassic World.
Either way, I feel like after the first one, they still shouldn't have made like a Jurassic Park theme park. Like, why did you keep going with it?
Money, obviously.
But I mean, like, that's what we're just talking about, like, you know, the plot hinging on something. It's like every movie hinges on something happening.
Can't have a door without a hinge, right?
Yeah.
Door without a hinge.
But yeah, going back to Inside Out, that's a, you know, she's not like dumb, but she's sadness. Like no one wants to be sadness.
Yeah.
So the movie is all about sadness.
I
want to
be sadness.
Trying to be someone else.
But
at the end.
Okay. But then there's the short film before, Lava.
Ah.
That one, I love that one either just as much or even more than Inside Out. I have the song on my phone.
No.
I loved it so much.
It was so cheesy.
Yeah, I'm sorry, I'm in touch with my feelings. Apparently you're not. I'm a very emotional person.
Like, it was cute, but it was just kind of like, eh. Like,
yeah,
though, the last short that I saw like that was, what was it, like, Paper Airplane or something?
Ooh,
That Disney one that won, like, an Oscar or something?
That,
and that one is, like, for like no short film or short animation can live up to that one anymore. Like, that one was so good. So, like, I judge everything based off that one.
Mm-hmm.
You haven't seen that one?
Nope.
Oh, you gotta look at that one. That one's really good. I fell in love in that one.
Yeah, but see.
Yeah. Well, favorites. What are some favorites? What are, like, some... Getting a text.
I don't know. My favorite, like, big blockbuster one would probably either be Jurassic World or Fury Road. I mean, that's, like, a big go-to thing to say because they're both really well made. Jurassic World, especially because, like, the prospect of the new... They're making a trilogy, and Colin Trevorrow, the director, says he wants it to be, like, the original Star Wars trilogy where a different person directs it every time, so he's stepping down. So that's exciting. But also Fury Road, because it's, like, what George Miller wanted to do with the original Mad Max films, but now he has the technology, so he did it, and it's great.
Yeah.
My favorite movie, I think, of the summer was Irrational Man, which was a Woody Allen film.
Yeah,
you just said that.
Yeah, I haven't seen that.
It's Joaquin Phoenix and Emma Stone, and it's this film that's a lot like... Did you guys in high school have to read Crime and Punishment?
No.
We had to? Doesn't mean I did.
Okay.
Yeah.
Well,
right, like,
pretty much the best way to explain Crime and Punishment, the book, but also helps explain Irrational Man as a movie, is some guy commits a crime, thinks because he committed the perfect crime... He's going to get away with it, and he's going to feel no remorse whatsoever because he feels like he did the right thing killing this person. And then, of course, because he meets a beautiful girl who he falls in love with, he starts feeling a little bit of empathy for the murder that he just committed and would have gotten away with.
Interesting.
Yeah.
Interesting. Noah, did you have any favorites this year?
Yes.
Okay.
What was your favorite?
Oh, yeah.
We have a show.
All right,
we have to actually talk about
that. I think if I had to pick a favorite summer movie,
yes,
I would probably go with Mission Impossible.
Oh, I totally forgot about Mission
Impossible.
Yeah, absolutely right.
Yes.
That movie was so much fun.
Yeah.
I haven't seen any of them.
I really liked
such a fun
too.
Movie,
but That's not like a summer movie, you know?
Yeah.
And Mission Impossible was
such a fun movie. I totally forgot about that one.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. That was a great movie.
Oh, another favorite, though, is San Andreas.
You saw San Andreas?
Yes. What a laugh.
Damn, I wanted to see that.
No, definitely see it.
That's the one with Colton Haynes from Arrow and The Rock, right?
Yeah.
And Alexander Daddario. You gotta see The Rock.
Yeah, you gotta see
The Rock.
Yeah. Yeah, that's like law. You have to see The Rock movie.
I mean, you know what you're going into.
I really wanted to see that one.
I haven't seen Hercules, though. So.
I haven't seen Hercules either. I had two favorites, and they're very different. Mission Impossible, now that you say it, like, yeah, definitely Mission Impossible. I really enjoyed Ant-Man. And I really, really enjoyed Before We Go. I talked about this on your show.
Yeah, I don't know. At some points, I didn't really like Before We Go, but it was a good movie overall.
It was like, you got Noah and Nick, or no, Noah and Felix. Have you heard of Before We Go?
No. says no. I think I've heard of it, yes. I've never seen it.
It's
Chris Evans,
Captain America's first directorial debut.
Ooh.
And it stars him and...
Alice Eve.
Yes, I've totally heard of that. Oh my gosh.
I like watched that on a whim in Los Angeles, and I don't know, like, I just really enjoyed it, because like over the summer, like, everything is just like big blockbusters and that kind of stuff. This was like a very like sweet, innocent little story that took place over one night between two characters, and it was like a character study almost. Mm-hmm. And it was really different than anything else, and I really enjoyed it. Like, it wasn't like the greatest movie at all.
Yeah.
It was just I really had a good time with it.
Yeah.
So yeah, it was really good. Don't need to press enter on this computer.
Nope.
You're fine. Okay, cool. Okay, cool. So those were some of the movies and stuff. Let's look forward a little bit to some upcoming movies. I know just this weekend Black Mass came out.
I really want to see Black Mass.
I so badly want to see Black
Mass. Like, the fact that, I think we should make it a Flickr movie, that we should all see as a Flickr group.
Yeah.
Only problem is, this weekend and 2 weekends after that, I'm going to be away.
We'll make sure that it's during one of those weekends then.
Please don't. Like, I really want to see Black Mass.
Tony's shaking his head, like, yeah.
Everyone wants to see the Black Ass, you know?
Black Ass would be good.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
You guys told me to put my filter on, jeez.
So for those that don't know, that's kind of Johnny Depp's return to, like, being amazing and not being a pirate.
Yeah.
Even though those movies are great, too.
Even his performance in Pirates of the Caribbean that was, like, stellar. Because, like,
when he originally,
like, started doing that, the director said, no, what are you doing? He's like, hey, you hired me.
Yeah, exactly.
Let me do
trust
this.
Trust me.
And it was
pretty. I heard about that, yeah.
The only thing, though, is I feel like every character that he plays is a little bit off hinge. I'd love to just see Johnny Depp play, like, you know, normal Joe Blow type
guy. Like, just like grocery store shopping Johnny Depp.
Yeah.
So, like, just doing a mundane.
Like, everything
really
he does.
Everyone can do that.
Is like an insane person, though.
Yeah, that's the beauty of it, you know? He really is a big character.
I don't know. I like seeing people play people out of, like, their comfort zone. And the weird thing is, for Johnny Depp, out of his comfort zone is his comfort zone.
Yeah, Johnny Depp out of his comfort zone would be like being a normal person. Yeah.
I don't know. I kind of want to see him do something just average.
Yeah.
But we'll see. Probably won't happen.
Yeah, Black Mass came out September 19th. It got a lot of praise at TIFF, so that's very exciting. Another movie I'm really looking forward to is The Martian with Matt Damon.
Yes.
When he goes and gets stuck on Mars. And he has to, like, survive on Mars for 4 years by growing trees and stuff.
It's like the prequel to Interstellar.
But
yeah, right?
Oh, yeah.
I am not a fan. I'm kind of done with space movies right now.
That's
I'd be okay if we don't do another
space
movie. Space
movies are so hot right now.
Yes.
But even though space is, like, so
cool. Oh, sorry.
Right now.
I don't mean Star Wars. Star Wars is okay. Keep coming out with those. But, like, movies about, like, people being trapped in space, like, Mars,
Interstellar, that's one of its problems, though.
Gravity.
It's losing, it lost the race, you know?
Hate to say it, but there's two new alien movies coming out soon.
There's two new alien movies as well?
Oh my gosh.
But the one thing I did notice with the Martian trailer is that, if you watch the trailer, it's actually, it put some, like, rock and roll music in it.
Yeah.
So to me, it felt more like an endurance movie and less of a space movie. It just took place in space, you know?
That's a good point.
I feel like you're just trying to discredit me, Noah, and I'm not okay with it.
A lot of it looks like it takes place, it looks...
A lot of it's on Earth.
A lot of it is on Earth. Like, it looks like it's an Apollo 11 type of, like, they're stuck in space, but a lot of it's also on Earth, like, trying to figure out how to get them.
Yeah.
Which I think is cool, like, kind of like a modern Apollo 11, whereas, like, gravity is the whole thing is in space, you know? So, that could be definitely interesting, for sure.
I definitely think they're going to do some, like, interesting marketing to get people to come see another stuck in space movie.
Yeah. It's based on a book.
Yeah,
I read
the book.
You read the book?
Yeah.
The book's good?
It's great. By Andy Weir. Man.
Yeah.
Cool. The other thing, though, is I feel like nowadays, if you tell people that, like, you read the book for a movie and you didn't like the movie because of how far away it was from the source material, people just won't care. Like, I told people I read the Wolf of Wall Street book, and that's why I didn't like the Wolf of Wall Street movie. But, you know, it's whatever.
I just don't really, like, consider the movie, how, like, the movie compares to the book anymore, because, like, as I've, like, gone more and more in depth on, like, learning film theory and film everything, I'm like, it's just a different medium. I can't really compare it all.
I've learned. I've watched 8 Harry Potter movies, and I've read 7 Harry Potter books. I know they're just going to be completely different.
The math doesn't work out.
I had to accept that.
But yet, every single time, like, a movie based on a book comes out, everyone just complains, and I'm like, people, it's
it
happens
medium.
Every time. What are you expecting?
I completely agree. It's just a complete reason.
I mean, there are some, though, that do pretty well.
What are you saying?
The quote, it's basically saying, the movie isn't based on the book. The movie and the book are both based on the same idea.
Story.
Yeah.
Oh.
So you gotta look at it that way. You
I like that. I like that.
Yes.
Yeah.
That's nice. That's nice. Enjoy that.
The Jurassic Park book, for example, like, Spielberg was talking with Michael Crichton. They were friends, and they were working on a screenplay while Michael Crichton was writing the book. And so Spielberg helped write the book. And before the book was even finished writing, Spielberg was already planning the movie. And the book and the movie are, like, the same plot, but two different, completely different ideas. Like, the book is, like, very, like, sci-fi thriller, as opposed to the movie, which is very, like, shock and awe, drama, folly of man, stuff
interesting.
Like that. It's really good.
That's cool. Interesting.
So what else do we have coming out this year?
Yeah, so The Martian, that's coming out October 2nd. The Steve Jobs movie.
Same thing with The Martian. Like,
yeah.
Seen too many space movies? We've seen too many Steve Jobs.
Well, this comes out October 23rd with Michael Fassbender. It's directed by Danny Boyle, who did Slumdog Millionaire, and stars the same screenwriter, Aaron Sorkin, as Social Network.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
So it's going to have that same kind of feel, which, like, they made a Facebook movie work, you know, so, yeah. I wish, I think Fincher was rumored to be director for this as well, but
mm-hmm.
obviously that fell through because Danny Boyle.
Yeah.
But, you know, Slumdog Millionaire is fantastic. So, that I think that'll be really interesting. Like I didn't care it really at all until I saw that Aaron Sorkin was the screenwriter, and then that kind of piqued my interest, just because of Social Network and how he did that.
I don't know. I didn't see the other Steve Jobs movie, so I feel like I'm gonna have to see both before.
Nah, they're
different.
Like,
I know, but just to compare them though, it'd be kind of cool if I saw both.
It's mostly the performance though. Like there's 3 technically. There's also Pirates of Silicon Valley, which is also
that's a great movie.
That one's great. And it's more about, like, the conflict between the two, Bill Gates and Steve Jobs, and their rise. Then the Ashton Kutcher one is good, but I didn't like his performance very much as Steve Jobs. But the new one with Michael Fassbender, Steve Wozniak, the Woz, saw it. And
he saw it at, what, TIFF?
He said he thought that was Steve Jobs on screen.
Mm.
He was completely convinced.
What did you think of Seth Rogen, though, as his counterpart?
He never really. I don't know. I didn't read that part of the interview. I only read the transcripts that were included in like Entertainment Weekly.
I find it kind of funny though that he said, "Oh yeah, you know they did a great Steve Jobs." It's like, what about you? How do you think they did you?
Yeah.
Like I feel like that's the important thing. Like if one day you know someone makes a biopic about me, I'm probably gonna say, "Oh yeah, you know I like how they did me. Now I like how they did my best friend Michael Mitchell." Like, then what do you think about the other performance of the person that played you? Like, that's the important thing. Obviously, we can't ask the dead man how we think he did as Steve Jobs.
Yeah, well, I think the Woz and the Kutcher Jobs were really good, though. I thought that was the better performance as opposed to Kutcher. No offense to Kutcher, he's great. But
so you're saying if they combined, I guess, according to sources... If they combine the Wozniak from the Ashton Kutcher movie and the Steve Jobs from this one, you'd have a good Steve Jobs movie.
That's true.
Yes. The problem, I think, with the Kutcher performance is that Kutcher was most definitely picked because he looked like Steve Jobs.
Yeah, he looks like,
because,
really
yes,
like him.
The old, like, young Steve Jobs looks exactly like that 70s show. What's his character's name in that?
I don't remember.
You know what I'm talking about.
Yeah, I know.
So, I don't know. Kelso, thank you.
Oh,
yeah. Well, who did I think?
The only thing is, Ashton Kutcher hasn't really been in anything like super amazing in a while.
Punked.
He was Punked.
Man, classic. Punked the movie. Oh my gosh.
But yes, I definitely think it was based on.
What's Punked?
Haven't seen it.
It was a TV show.
Okay.
Shout out to other Flickr Film Society members texting me, "You suck." Just kidding, you guys sound great. Shout out.
Oh, great.
Not say your name, because otherwise I'll fucking hurt you.
Yeah, you don't want to
slander. So Steve Jobs comes out October 23rd. Another movie I'm really looking forward to is Revenant.
Ooh,
talk about yes. Revenant.
The movie where Leonardo DiCaprio almost died twice and three guys were sent to the ER. Man, might be one of the greatest films ever, but also the most dangerous.
The only thing that's kind of weird, though, is I haven't actually seen anything for it, but you guys saw that article about how DiCaprio at some point is going to play a character with, like, 23 different personalities, right?
I haven't heard of that. What's it about?
It's a biopic about a guy, I guess, who had, like, you know, really bad multiple personality disorder,
mm-hmm.
and I guess they want to do a movie about him because he had, like, 23 different ones. The weird thing is, since that article, I haven't really heard too much about the movie, and I think it's supposed to come out next year.
Really?
Which is weird, because I feel like you would have heard more about it then.
Yeah, I don't know.
That reminds me of, like, Tom Hardy in Legend, which looks great, by the way. But, like, because he has to play, like, two different people.
Yeah.
One who's more the stable brother of the Prey twins, and the other one who's, like, more battling with himself. Kind of like in, have you seen Bronson?
No.
That's definitely one of Tom Hardy's more stellar performances. It's Charles Bronson, most famous criminal in the world. Man, it's great.
All right, I'm back. Sorry, I had to change a camera battery.
That's fine.
This live recording thing is crazy.
Yeah.
Yeah, so Revenant, that comes out, I think in January 2016.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
With Leo, Tom Hardy, directed by the same guy who did Birdman, Alejandro Inarritu.
Birdman was good.
Birdman
after
was good.
Birdman, I feel like I would see anything that he directed.
Yeah.
I guess it's a one-hit wonder like the Wachowskis.
Yeah, I heard this...
Shots fired.
Yeah, I heard, Revenant used all natural lighting.
Yes.
The whole thing was naturally lit,
that's
which,
cool.
If you know film, means that you did not
impossible.
Want to be on that set because that was probably hell.
Yeah.
Like, I can't even imagine, because the whole trail and everything, that's all shot on locations, all outdoors, clouds are constantly moving. I can't even imagine, like, getting that past the producers, like, yeah, we're going to do this film, all natural lighting, like, rejected on my desk. That's crazy.
Yeah, like, I have...
Although, after Birdman, though, I feel like, if someone said, it's like, hey, you know, I can do this, usually you'd say no. But then he's like, yeah, but I made Birdman.
That's
and then,
true.
Like,
having
you know,
an Oscar
could probably pull it
helps
off.
You. Having an Oscar probably helps you.
Well, I don't know. DiCaprio still hasn't got an Oscar, and he keeps getting hired, so I don't know.
Any other movies that we're looking forward to coming out in the next couple months, maybe?
I think.
Besides Star Wars, because that's a little bit later.
Star Wars.
What'd you say?
All the Star Wars.
Deadbeat? You looking forward to Deadbeat?
Oh, yeah.
Shout out. Yeah, you know what? No, let's take a second. Let's plug some Flickr films, because we're Flickr. Shout out to Deadbeat, which is Carson Rochow, his first directorial debut, right? His first?
Yeah.
His first?
Yeah, I think he, I don't know.
Probably, yeah.
I mean,
it's nice. Yeah.
Yeah.
No, I mean, through Flickr. Yeah.
Yeah. This is his first real film.
Yeah, so Deadbeat, it's a dark comedy. That'll be fun. What were you on the set, Noah?
Oh, I was the DP.
DP, I was lighting, so it's going to look beautiful.
Yeah, I read the script over the summer, and it's actually pretty good.
Yeah, no, it's pretty good. I'm going to enjoy it. And then the other first production we have going on right now is Shit Man, directed by Adam Falkelman, who's done Strangers, and he did one other film. I forgot.
Hey, Tyler, are we going to get a Flesh of Light 3, or...?
Are we getting Flesh of Light? I don't know. Because
I kind of want some Flesh of Light 3.
I don't know. So yeah, shout out to those two productions going on right now. They're filming this weekend, and yeah, look forward to those coming out soon. So if we're not going to talk about favorite movie or movies we're looking forward to anymore, I think it's time we play a little game.
Okay.
Hope you guys are ready for this.
I'm ready for any game you can throw at me, Tyler.
We are about to play Shia LaBeouf or Gary Busey.
Oh boy.
Okay.
Oh my gosh.
So how do you play?
So this is how you play Shia LaBeouf or Gary Busey. I'm going to give you a quote. And you have to tell me, was it Shia LaBeouf or Gary Busey that said it?
We get key points, or?
Yes, we're keeping points. We're keeping points, and what's going to happen is we're going to keep points throughout the entire year, throughout the entire length of the show.
Okay.
And I'm going to say right now, whoever has the most points at the end wins something. I don't know what that is, because I just said that now, but you're going to win something. So
$1 iTunes gift card.
$1 iTunes gift card, there you go. So I'm going to say a quote. I'm going to start with you, Noah, because you're right here, and you're going to have to tell me, is it Gary Busey or Shia LaBeouf?
Alright. Hit me.
Okay, let's see.
Literally just hit you, sorry. That was so rude.
Let's see. Five parts of my brain contain alien power. Whatever I do or say cannot be denied on the intergalactic highway of existence. These are actual quotes by one of these two people.
Are these movie or like personal quotes?
It could be from a movie, they could be personal quotes. Well, I think all of these are personal, honestly, but they could be from a movie as well.
Might have to throw that one to Gary.
Do you think Gary Busey?
Yeah, okay.
You're correct. That was a Gary Busey quote. You want to
go parts around? On my thank God I didn't get that one.
What's up?
Like, go around to each person?
Yeah, yeah, we're just going around each person. Oh, no. I only have, like, 5 quotes from each, basically, okay. So. Let's see. So this is going to be for you, Felix.
Hold on.
Thank you.
I'll be a loser. Under
pressure. There's a way to do an acid trip like Harold and Kumar, and there's a way to be on acid. There's a way to do an acid trip like Harold and Kumar, and then there's a way to be on acid.
Well, I feel
Gary Busey or Shia LaBeouf.
I feel like Gary Busey wouldn't know who Harold and Kumar are. I feel like that's just what he calls like his drug dealers. So I'm gonna have to say like Shia LaBeouf.
That was Shia LaBeouf.
Okay,
yeah.
Just
thank you.
That was a lot of.
I got both wrong.
I got both wrong so far. Oh my god. Yeah, some of these are tough, honestly. Let's see.
Can I get just do it? Can I have you?
Yeah, just do it. I thought about putting that one in, but I was like, no. Okay, ready?
Yeah.
This is for you, Brian.
I'm not ready at all, but okay.
Probably the sexiest woman I know is my mother. She's an ethereal angel. Nobody looks like that woman. If I could meet my mother and marry her, I would. I would be with my mother now if she weren't my mother, as sick as that sounds.
I know Donald Trump said that about his daughter. so let's see, I don't know. I'm gonna go with Gary Busey.
Oh, that was a Shia LaBeouf quote.
Damn. Ooh. Can someone please Google Shia LaBeouf's mom for me? Just so we can figure out what he's talking about.
I didn't Google. I don't know what she looks like.
You just get the
I'm
mom from
right
even
now.
Stevens.
Do it right now. Okay. So it's a 1-1-0.
I think I've seen pictures of her. Oh, meow. Jesus.
Wait, really? Let me see. Is she really?
Shia Side A. Side Seed?
Wait,
side.
Let me see this.
Side.
Wait, click on it.
I can't actually see
the picture.
I can't see. Click on it, please.
You get enlarge the picture.
Enlarge it. I want it big. That's right. That was weird. That was weird, wasn't it?
No, I would not. I would not marry her.
Not really.
No. I would like let her like heal me with like chakras or something.
She looks like she's a healer. She looks like she's a healer for sure.
Yeah, I see it. Although that's what she looks like now. Like we don't know what she looks like, you know. When she was Shia LaBeouf's age.
Okay.
If you
no.
find it, let me know.
Yes. I'm throwing this one back to you. We're gonna go one more round around because I don't have enough.
Young Shia LaBeouf.
Young Shia LaBeouf.
Yes. Look at him. Can we please like put
I'm
that
throwing
in
this back
the
to you.
Video?
Okay. Here we go. I sent him. He's talking about. I'd put the director, but it would probably give it away. So I sent him videotapes of me and my girlfriend having sex, and that's how I got the job.
That definitely.
This is tough.
You were about to. You were like, yeah, no.
I'm gonna throw that. I mean, I want to say Shia LaBeouf. The last two have been Shia LaBeouf. I don't know how. I'll go Shia LaBeouf.
Oh, that's Shia LaBeouf! Right, yeah.
Wow, I'm bad at this game.
That was talking about how he got his role for Nymphomaniac.
Oh, good movie.
Yeah,
well, that makes sense.
Something like that. Okay. Felix.
My captain. Okay, my captain.
Let's see. I'm trying to find a good one here. I'll tell you this, you have to remember to chase and catch your dreams, because if you don't, your imagination will live in empty spaces. Live in empty spaces, and that's nowhere land. Shia LaBeouf or Gary Busey?
Because that really reminds me of the video, so I don't want to say Shia LaBeouf, because oh my god.
But maybe I'm tricking you. Maybe I thought you would think that, and that's why I put it in there.
I've seen like the full Shia LaBeouf video, and I don't remember that, but I don't know, I think I was like laughing, but I'm gonna think you just abused me. I think that's Gary Busey.
Oh, you got it!
Yay,
that was Gary Busey.
So happy.
Wow. So you guys both have 2, right?
Sweet.
Wow. All right.
I have
so
-5. So
you need to get on the board here. This
okay.
is the last. This is the last round. This
uh-huh.
is the last. Okay.
I got this.
Okay.
No help.
Let's see. Let me find a good one. All right. Here's the final quote.
Uh-huh.
Shia LaBeouf, Gary Busey.
Uh-huh.
When Tom Cruise walks outside his house, he doesn't pick his nose. From the minute he leaves his door to the minute he comes back home, he doesn't pick his nose. Now that's a certain way of living your life that I have no ambitions toward.
I can relate to that. I
relate to that.
I can relate to that. I'm going to go with Gary Busey?
No.
Damn it!
Shia LaBeouf! Ryan! 0-2.
I don't know my...
Can we like stop now that we're on top?
Yeah, no, that was the final round. All right. I don't have enough
push. Sweet.
Yeah.
Thank you.
So, final score, Noah 2, Felix 2, Ryan 0. I can throw you guys a tiebreaker.
I don't know. No, I'm fine.
Yeah, give him a tiebreaker.
Okay, all right. So, we'll keep it 2-2, nothing. No. Fantastic.
Ugh.
That was fun. That was fun.
I hated this game. We're never playing it again.
Okay, so let's talk. We talked about movies we saw, movies we look forward to. Let's talk about movie news. First up on the block is, let's just get out of the way. Let's talk a little bit about Star Wars. Let's talk about how Star Wars is opening a day earlier in the UK, and also how they rented out every IMAX screen in every IMAX theater for an entire month. That's crazy.
That's crazy. I mean, Disney, you know?
I mean, yeah.
I'm surprised they haven't bought back everything that Marvel used to own yet.
Yeah. What thoughts on Star Wars? What's up?
Well, I think that J.J. Abrams is doing a wonderful job of keeping everything true. It's like, not just in terms of practical effects like everybody talks about, but in terms of like the character work and how he's stepping down as director and going with the original trilogy directed by the people that I don't remember their names. But I think that in terms of renting out all the IMAX theaters, I think that's just... Disney giving everybody the middle finger and being like, "We're Disney. This is Star Wars. Nobody will care."
Yeah.
Except for ever, like, nobody cares that.
No, I mean, they're
yeah.
gonna make.
No consumer will care.
No consumer will care. Everybody will be like, "Well, yeah. What else would they do?"
Yeah. So I'm looking forward to it. Noah, what are your thoughts?
Can't wait.
Very enthusiastic. Can't wait.
Well, here's the thing. I haven't seen Star Wars since I was like younger.
Right.
I know. So like. I still have time to catch up.
Yeah, that's true.
You know,
that's true.
I feel bad. I wish I was more excited.
Yeah.
Everyone else
is
excited.
Yeah.
I feel like...
It's okay, man.
I mean, I saw Star Wars for the first time a couple years ago, so...
Yeah.
That's probably better, though, because I don't really remember it. I just remember it was cool.
I just introduced my girlfriend to Star Wars over the summer, and now she's hooked.
I did watch A New Hope over summer.
I watched it in order. I did... Well, not
you
the
did one, two, three.
The true order. I did 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
Yeah. Well, I thought... Me and my girlfriend thought about doing Machete order, which is... 4-5, then you go back to the prequels, you skip 1, go 2-3, and then skip ahead to 6. So 4-5, 2-3, 6.
And you just never watch one?
You just never watch one. One is irrelevant. One is completely irrelevant.
Why is it called the Machete Order?
It's because you kind of just chop it up. You chop it up and whatever.
They're like the Machete movies. I'm like, there's...
Yeah, Machete are great movies too.
Machete in space.
Yeah. That was the thing, right? And Machete Kills, he's like, yeah, coming back Machete in space.
Oh my god.
Yeah.
You didn't ask me what I think about the...
What do you think about
Star Wars movies?
Star Wars.
I don't know. Considering how much flack that everyone gave for the prequels, I feel like J.J. Abrams is going to have a tough time because everyone, in critics, consumers alike, are going to be watching this film looking for every tiny little thing and any reason to say that the originals are always going to be the best. And no matter how many times that they try to bring this back and tell more of the story... The originals will always be the best, so... You know what, I say good luck, J.J. Abrams. You know, some people didn't like you when you did Star Trek. I honestly still haven't seen them. But good luck with Star Wars.
Yeah, it's a lot of pressure.
I give you my best.
If someone came up to me and offered me that job, I'd be like, I really don't think I can do it. And they just got, God, I forgot his name. The Jurassic World director is now doing the 9th one.
Yeah.
So
but
he
they
went
already
for,
know who's doing the 9th
yeah,
film?
Yeah.
We already know who's doing the 8th, too.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, that makes sense.
That guy's went from creating like a small indie to Jurassic World to now Star Wars.
Yeah.
Like, that dude's got to be living on cloud nine.
He's great.
Yeah.
He's a great writer, though.
Yeah.
But I mean, I think for like J.J. Abrams, I think that he'll be fine because he's not George Lucas.
Yeah.
Yeah. And
I feel like
and the writer for Empire and Return,
Lawrence Kasdan.
And what?
Lawrence Kasdan.
Lawrence Kasdan. Thank you, Cody.
There we go. Thank you.
Lawrence Kasdan, who did the originals, is
we should
screenwriting
just give,
this one.
Cody a whiteboard. Just be like, whenever we say something we don't know, just have be like
text us.
So that's a little bit about Star Wars. I mean, obviously like the whole world's excited for Star Wars.
Yeah, I know when Tyler was on my show last week, right?
It was last week.
We spent most of the time talking about superheroes, so I wouldn't be surprised if we were all Star Wars this episode.
Yeah, we don't need to harp on Star Wars anymore than you know the rest of the entire film industry. I mean, we could easily, but we don't need to. So let's go ahead and move on. This is something I haven't heard a lot about, but it is a thing. There is a Godzilla vs. King Kong movie in the works.
I wonder where you heard that from.
Was that on your show?
Oh, was it? I think it was.
Oh, I don't know. Yes, so what was it? Paramount sold or gave the rights to King Kong to Warner Brothers, who has the rights to Godzilla. Or so. Yeah. That's either it or it's the other way around?
Legendary and Warner Brothers to... No, Universal passed on Legendary, the most recent iteration of the new King Kong.
Right.
Yeah, so it's to Warner Brothers. Legendary.
That's right. Yeah, to Warner Brothers. So, because there's a King Kong sequel called King Kong Skull Island, King of Skull Island or something like that.
Kong Skull Island.
Kong Skull Island, there it is. And after that, they want to make a King Kong Godzilla movie, which, like, I mean, sure,
okay.
I don't know who's asking for it, but...
People will see it.
People will see it. I'll see it. Like, I think that'll be crazy.
I still have to see the King Kong movies.
Yeah, the original King Kong's, of course, a classic. And then the Peter Jackson King Kong is insane.
Which one?
Is?
I don't know. One of the older ones.
Really?
Yeah,
I haven't seen either of the Godzillas.
Yeah, Godzillas. There's so many iterations of Godzilla. I haven't seen the new Godzilla.
Godzilla!
Have you seen the original Godzillas?
I've seen the original Godzilla.
Yeah, like, I've never seen this one. It's like, they did make an original King Kong versus Godzilla. Never saw that one. It looks like it's made in 62. So
interesting.
We missed it.
You missed it, damn.
So they're doing a reboot of the movie, really? So they rebooted one, they rebooted the other, and now they're rebooting the competition.
Pairing. Yeah, the pairing.
So it's like, what are they going to do, Freddy versus Jason as a reboot in a couple years after rebooting Freddy and then rebooting Jason?
Probably.
I don't know, I haven't seen any of those either. I'll work on it.
So that's King Kong vs. Godzilla. I mean, we don't need to harp on that anymore either.
First
time you hear about it? Yeah. It's crazy. Like, alright, whatever.
Freddy vs. Godzilla.
Jungle Book teaser.
Ooh,
trailer.
Yes. Scarlett Johansson.
So I was trying to figure this out. Scarlett Johansson is the snake.
She's Ka.
Ka.
She's so hot.
Not gonna lie. She could just, like, if she just, like, talked to me for the rest of my life, I would never have to talk to another girl.
Yeah.
Honestly.
I brought up a lot of criticism when I heard her voice in The Snake. It doesn't sound right. But then someone reminded me that she was a cell phone in Her. And I was like, oh, yeah. She could do voice. Like, she could voice over pretty good. So maybe the trailer was just weird.
I think the one thing that's going to be weird is the fact that it's not like she's the one character who's voicing over an animal. This is the entire movie.
Yeah.
It's all going to be, any animal you see on screen is going to be voiced by an actor.
Yeah.
Like, it's not like they're CGI-ing like
and
parts of their face
it's
on
some
the animal.
Crazy actors. Scarlett Johansson, Bill Murray.
Who's Bill Murray?
I thought Bill Murray was in the other Jungle Book movie that they're making.
Nope.
No, he's in this one.
Oh,
he's in this one, yeah.
Is he supposed to be Boo? Or no, what's his name?
I do not know who Bill Murray is going to portray. I do not know. Idris Elba's in it, directed by Jon Favreau, who did Iron Man, Chef. Chef was a great movie.
Although, I can't remember who... Oh, yeah. All I know is, even if this Jungle Book movie is the best, the best Shere Khan I've ever seen is Michael Mitchell at BCC High School when they put on the Jungle Book. He's the best Shere Khan, so whatever.
It's been so long since I've seen the Jungle Book. I need to go back and see it.
Yeah, Warner Brothers is also making one. Jungle Book Origins, there we go. With Andy Serkis to direct it.
Really?
Yeah.
Andy Serkis directing.
Right.
Interesting.
Sure.
Benedict Cumberbatch is going to be Shere Khan. So, and Christian Bale is going to be Bajira. Kate Blanchett is going to be Ka. And
what's it with all these girls playing snakes?
And Rowan Chad is Mowgli. So
I mean, I don't care.
Interesting.
But I feel like that's some weird implications there. But
interesting. So that's that. That's Jungle Book. I need to go back and watch the Jungle Book. We Are Your Friends. Did you guys hear anything about this movie?
I heard about it, didn't see it.
I didn't see it.
Totally gonna see it.
Hey, Felix, because it seems that you're our chief googler at the moment, can you please check if Zac Efron was a producer on that movie? Because I know he's with the main star,
I think so.
And it wouldn't surprise me if he was also one of the producers.
Yeah. So, We Are Your Friends is a Zac Efron film about him being a DJ for a club or something, and it's, you know, a bunch of techno music and that kind of stuff.
Yeah.
And
how could it fail?
Yeah, how can a movie like that fail? Well, it did. It opened fourth worst debut for a movie, opening at 2,000 plus screens.
What was first?
I think first was like...
Fantastic Four?
No, it was some sort... It was some, like... Google that, the worst film opening. But it was like some like animated kids thing or something about and a big balloon adventure.
It was such a low budget too. It was only like $6 million budget, but they only made four.
Yeah, it's pretty bad.
I was not a producer, by the way.
The first time I heard about it.
He did not produce it.
Was when I found out it was the fourth Wish.
That was your first time? Yeah, that's not good.
Problems.
Yeah.
That I didn't hear about it.
Exactly. That's a major problem. I saw one trailer one time.
Yeah.
For that movie.
I saw the same trailer twice, but I only saw like the one trailer. I don't know. It also didn't really tell me what the movie was about. Like, okay, he's a DJ. Okay, he like leaves his friends, but like, what else is it about?
It's mostly like about like not really. It's kind of like the big like archetype almost plot where like, oh yeah, someone's like working really really hard with his friends, and his friends are supporting him to get really famous, and then he gets to that point, and then he has to turn the back.
Yeah.
On it. But it's also about like DJ culture in the San Fernando Valley, which is a big thing.
Yeah.
Because that's like right behind Hollywood, so it's mostly about like DJ culture,
okay,
with a backdrop of that plot. No worst openings. First worst opening ever is Oogie Loves in the Big Balloon Adventure.
That's it, Oogie Loves. That's it. I knew it was something weird.
The third worst is
Thank you, Justin.
The
Justin Austin is letting me know. Thank you, Justin.
There we go. Thanks, Justin.
It's weird that I knew that.
What's two and three?
Two is Delgo. Don't know what that is. Three is Saw, the 10th anniversary. Ooh, 12 is All Dogs Go to Heaven, too. I love that film. Oh, eight is Spider-Man and Men in Black 2.
Oh,
God. Spider-Man, the first one?
No, yeah, I saw that, too. It came out at, like, a weird... When was that release date?
Is that... Like, which one? Spider-Man, Men in Black 2?
Yeah, it was, like... I don't know what that was.
Was that, like, a joint movie that they did?
It must have been, yeah. Because it's not... It wasn't
this.
The original Spider-Man.
Wait,
no, yeah, it's a weird, yeah.
What is this? So was it like a double feature that released?
I guess so, yeah, because it's not that Spider-Man that you're thinking of.
Yeah, but like why? That's what?
Why? Yeah, I don't
know. It's not like how they're making like a, what's it called, like a 21 Jump Street Men in Black crossover, which they are doing. It's just combining two major hits into one double feature. Seems like a foolproof plan.
Yeah, so it was just a Spider-Man, Men in Black. You just watch back to back or something, I guess.
That's
strange.
Yeah. That's a weird combo.
That is a weird combo, which is probably why
I
didn't do good.
You're watching a sequel after.
Yeah.
What's the point?
Yeah.
It's really confusing.
It was weird. So that was We Are Your Friends. Was Zac Efron a producer on that?
No, he was not.
He was not a producer on that, Brian.
Have you seen the movie Parkland with Billy Bob Thornton? It's about JFK's assassination.
No.
Oh, it's a great film. It's probably not just because JFK is like my favorite man ever, but it's basically about like the people who are part of the assassination, not JFK at all.
That's cool.
And Zac Efron plays like the young lead surgeon that operated on him.
Oh,
and he did a really stellar job. I love it.
Yeah,
you know,
like, he's a good
Zac Efron
actor.
Isn't a bad actor. It's just I guess it was a he's just an okay actor, I guess.
No, I liked Zac Efron.
Yeah.
I mean,
you know
what
movie I
liked
him in? 17 Again.
17
Again.
I liked
17 Again.
I did not see the movie. I saw him in, what's the most recent movie I saw? He was in another movie with Miles Teller and The Human Torch.
That awkward moment.
Yeah, that was
that awkward
yeah.
moment. That's right.
I like that. That was actually not too bad.
I liked the movie too.
I remember reviewing it. It wasn't my favorite.
Yeah,
but
it
was all right.
I liked Zac Efron. Like his role in that movie was like, yeah. totally. I totally believe.
Have you seen Neighbors?
Yes, that's
I
movie.
Haven't.
I loved Neighbors.
Should I see Neighbors?
Neighbors.
No. You're a
fan.
See it with like other people. It's not fun to watch it by yourself. But if you're watching
it
with like people like in your dorm common
so
room,
find
like living room,
my friends with the naughtiest sense of humor ever, and then
or friends that go to parties.
Okay.
Yeah.
I just need friends
because we are your friends.
Aww, look at that, tying it back. That's great. That was good. Let's talk about Hardcore.
Yeah.
I know you just saw the trailer for this.
Yeah, I just watched
it. Cody's freaking out.
I just saw it.
Noah, did you
see I watched it today.
Yeah, you watched it today?
I've been wanting to watch it.
Yes. Yeah, so Hardcore is based off of a short 4-minute something YouTube video.
Shopping the GoPro.
My girlfriend was just like, Neighbors, yes! So much goodness, she said. So... Oh, she said so much hotness. Zac Efron is my competition. I guess I lose.
Oh, I thought you were talking about us.
Oh, probably.
I don't know.
Yeah, let's say that.
Blank.
Should I take off my shirt?
No.
Yeah, so, Hardcore is based off a 4-minute YouTube GoPro one-take video. And it's like this big action thing, first person, really cool looking. So, it's the same guy who directed that video He has a budget now, and studio was like, yeah, make a 90-minute movie. It's only an hour and a half. And it's all first person, and it's about, based on trailers, based off a guy who becomes like a cyborg and then just beats everybody's ass. In first person. So it looks violent as all hell.
RoboCop?
RoboCop first person or something, I guess. Yeah.
Okay.
Only he's not a cop.
He's just a badass.
So Roboman?
Yeah. Roboman.
Robo badass. There we go.
Yeah.
What is that? It's called Hardcore. So I guess when you know if they ever decide to make a porno parody, it's not gonna be hard to think of a name. Sorry.
None, because Hardcore's taken. So.
That's true. That category of that stuff is. I want to know that.
Me neither.
Yeah. So what are we thinking about this movie? Like, it's either going to be really cool or we're going to get a headache in 2 minutes. And
yeah, that's
I don't know.
That's your fear, Noah.
It has one of my favorite actors though, Charlton Copley. Great voice. He's in like all the Neil Blomkamp movies, like District 9 and Elysium. He's a great actor, and he looks like he plays like one or several characters in the film.
Okay.
And I'm excited for that. Yeah.
Yeah. I hate like the experimental form of film, but like I love when people try something different.
Yeah.
So
I tried to actually. I wanted to see if we could get the experimental part of Real Teal taken out, but then I was told we can't. So
I know. Didn't we take that out? I'm pretty sure we took that.
No, it's still there. It's just there? I wanted to get it taken out. Experimental is kind of weird when you give like people, just random people, the ability to turn in experimental films. Because then they send in a lot of just weird stuff.
They send in like Bill Nye episodes, you know, doing experiments.
It's
just horrible.
So I'm looking
forward to this. No, someone actually did that with like Pee Wee Sherman. They took like Pee Wee Sherman episode and just put a lot of weird filters over it.
Yeah, I saw that one.
This is not an experimental film. This is just, I don't know what this is, but I don't like it.
If you don't know what it is, it's art. It's experimental.
Yeah, exactly. So I can appreciate that they're definitely doing something different here.
I think I'll see it. I would see it for the concept.
I'll see it.
But I'm not exactly sold on the story.
I'm not sold on the story.
When 3D was young, it was very gimmicky, you know? They're like brushing stuff off, like blowing bubbles into the
camera.
Like, I'm worried it'll be that. Because even in the trailer, there was some weird. You know, it seemed like they're really playing with the format, which is great. It's very exciting. But I feel like it is going to come off a little cheesy because they are trying to make. They want it to be a first-person movie.
Yeah,
so
and so they're constrained to that. Like, that's it. Like, we can only have this one camera angle, which I think will help in some aspects, but also hinder a lot as well. So there's it's definitely going to be interesting.
It's experimental in its own sense.
Yeah. Yeah.
It's one of the first times that we've seen this. So I'm not expecting it to be the best movie, but I'm definitely expecting it to be significant.
Yeah for sure, for sure. I'm gonna appreciate it a lot.
Yeah.
I think.
The one thing that really bugged me in the trailer though was when it's very close to the beginning of the trailer. She's like asking him questions, and we see he nods his head.
Yeah.
I was like, oh, geez, here we go.
It's like a video game.
Yeah, but it really came around after.
Well, there's also like a couple of parts where he's like shaking his head, like because you know he's like reacting to things. It's weird.
Well, no, he's talking about like she asked him a question and
he just shakes his head no.
Yeah,
so we're just getting camera movement to tell the story.
I would much. Cool. It's cool because it like puts us in his view, or whatever. But I would much rather have
it
be a voice.
Yeah,
rather
than just
they're probably gonna have like, oh yeah, your voice was destroyed, but we got you all these cool things like a rotatable leg, but we couldn't like get you like text to speech voice, you know.
That's true.
And everything.
Although I don't know, after Ex Machina, I don't think if I want my robots to have voices. Not gonna lie.
I never saw Ex Machina. I heard a lot of good things.
It freaked me out.
Yeah.
Speaking of like experimental film, have you guys heard about Victoria?
No.
It's like taken after Birdman. It's an independent film. It's not like Birdman where they use like VFX and VFX to like hide the cuts between the one take. It's 2 hours and 20 minutes, one take.
Yeah.
Yes.
Wow. Are we seeing like the golden age of the long take now?
I think so. I think people are like pushing the limits of what it can do, and that's great.
Because we've seen it in Gravity, we've seen it in Birdman.
Yeah.
It looks like Hardcore is going to be a lot of long takes. The video it's based on was all one take, I believe. Victoria, I guess, is 2.5 hours, one shot.
The only thing is like it's so super cool for you like to challenge yourself because that's great and all. But you really put a lot of constraints on you. It's like,
yeah,
I'm gonna do this in one take.
That's why
like,
I think
Flash
of Light
was so brilliant.
If one of your extra
sneeze, you're screwed.
Really, I think that was
Yeah, that's why Flash of Light works so well, because it's all one shot.
So,
who
directed Flash of Light?
I directed.
I mean, leaving story aside, I think the one take was a very significant move.
Yeah, thank you. No, yeah,
appreciate
it. Flat, you know,
I mean, and you inspired. Birdman did come out after. So.
That's true. That's great.
Hey, so Tyler, if we decide to actually give this show like an actual name, I think we should just call it the Plug. Because every single person who's has made a plug.
Yeah,
just call the show The Plug.
That's great.
Okay, directed by Thomas Miller and done by Superhuman Studios, coming out, actually came out September 14th. It's going to a few film festivals. I don't know, because that's the director's job. I produced it and director of photography.
Nice.
Look it up on Vimeo.
You're
going to
put
it
in a Real Deal, right?
Twitter, the JF Carlson.
Yeah, dude.
Submit
to Real Deal.
Yeah, I'll submit it to Real Deal. Yeah, there we go. I'll do that.
Do
it. It's great, man.
Yeah, gotta put it in Real Deal.
Yeah.
Another plug. Actually, we are all members of the Real Teal Film Festival.
Yeah, we're talking about that at the end.
Okay.
A little bit. I have a special section. Okay, so we've talked about that. Let's see. I'll get into this last piece of news here. Pacific Rim 2 was announced it was delayed indefinitely, and then I think either today or yesterday it came out that Del Toro is still actively pursuing getting it created. So the studio was like, no, but he's like, screw you, yes.
Yeah. How's that one going
to
work?
Yeah. I don't know. Is he going to shop it around to other studios?
Is he allowed to?
Definitely make money.
That's what Whedon did with Serenity. He, like, Fox dropped him, and so he took it to Universal. So, because Fox didn't want to make Serenity at all.
Yeah, the only problem is that it is a sequel.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
We don't know what
that's a good point.
Play.
Yeah. I just saw Pacific Rim over the summer.
I still haven't seen it.
And, I don't know, I thought, like, it got cleaned up pretty good. Like, you know, they killed the bad guy and stuff.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know, like, what a sequel would entail exactly.
Well, it's gonna be
so, one of the robots is going to actually go evil, and then they're gonna have to use an upgraded version of that robot to fight that one.
Really?
Yeah.
That'd be awesome.
I don't know if that's actually what it is, but just what I know about sequels, it's probably what it's gonna be.
I feel like
that.
That's the next step, though. They had robots versus monsters, now you gotta do robots versus robots.
Yeah, so, you know how, like, we're all kind of wondering what they're gonna do with Frozen 2? You know they're going to give someone, like, a fire-based power is to go against Elsa. That's just how it's gonna work.
True.
Actually, though, it's gonna be about, like, the female lead in the film. It's gonna drop the male lead almost completely altogether. It's gonna go into the backstory of the female lead. Because that's what
we're talking about, Pacific Rim, or
we're talking about Pacific Rim. Because that's
when
Del Toro made the film, so it's supposed to be about.
I was confused.
Interesting. Okay,
we're talking about too many things here.
Okay, so that's pretty much all Pacific Rim 2 news, I guess.
Yeah.
That we needed to get out of the way here. I think you guys are ready for another game.
Let's do it.
Let's do another game. I'm excited for this game personally.
Jigsaw.
This is called the Shyamalan Shyamaloff.
Oh, yes.
I like this.
Yes. So, as we all know, the coveted M. Night Shyamalan is a master at some twist endings.
Yeah, it's actually called a Shyamalan twist.
It's called a Shyamalan twist. And at this point now, the biggest twist that he can make is a good movie.
Without a twist.
Without a twist. So, this is the Shyamalan. I want to ask each of you to pitch a movie. Kind of describe it in detail, and then you have to give it a distinctive twist at the end, like a twist ending, in your description, in your little pitch. We just had a pitch meeting at the Flickr meeting, so you should know what pitches are. You can go a little bit more in depth, I encourage it, than just like one sentence. We're gonna go one at a time, and we'll start with you, Brian.
Think up
a movie, and give it a great twist, and the winner gets a point. Right now, Noah and Felix are at 2. Brian, you're at 0.
We're continuing that score?
Oh. Yeah, that score continues the whole
through
everything. Yeah.
So let's see.
Here we go.
Like,
this is on the spot, too. This is on the spot. So this is like improv Shyamalan.
So there is this guy who figures out that he has superpowers, and his superpower is that he can change whatever happens in his environment, but he can only change it about every 5 minutes. He can't go forward, he can't go back, he can just change little things. He can't change everything, just little things. Like, you know, he could change a poster so it says something else, or the color of a flower. Small things.
So simple things, not a very powerful power.
Yeah.
Okay.
And he kind of spends the movie trying to figure out what he's going to do with this new power when a black hole opens up in the middle of New York, and he has to use his very small reality-bending powers to stop this black hole.
Okay.
And the twist ending is that he was actually in the hospital in a coma the entire time.
That's sad.
That's the twist ending that everyone seems to go with whenever they have like a dream movie. It's always like, it was always a dream, they were in a coma, blah, blah, blah.
Okay.
I'm already at 0 points, I don't care anymore.
Well, I don't like that ending too much. I'm not a big fan of the whole it was a dream thing.
So what do you think of the rest of the movie, though? In case I didn't just have to go through the twist ending.
I can see that, but like, really mundane, like, simple things, that could be interesting.
Yeah.
It would be hard to, like, dictate, like, you can change this, but you can't change, like, that, like, depending on how small the change is. I don't know. So, okay. Right now, you're the winner, but we have two more contestants.
Okay. Yay, for now.
Felix, I'm gonna go with you next.
Okay. So, let me tell you about a story about a man named Shia. This man Shia, he spends his entire life working very, very hard at being himself, being exactly himself, being Shia LaBeouf. He's an actor, he's a son, he may or may not be on meth. That's questionable. He's allegedly on methamphetamines.
True.
And you see, he like keeps going and doing these really crazy things ever since he went crazy and insane and like wore a paper bag over his head to red carpet like 3 years ago. But
that was 3 years ago, wow.
Yes, and everybody just like acts like he's insane, like he's crazy. And he gets like becoming this idea of Shia LaBeouf. He's becoming a living, breathing meme. He's Shia Meme LaBeouf. And so eventually as the film goes on, we see his rise and rise, then his slow, or not so slow, fall from grace as Shia LaBeouf. But then towards the end of the film, towards the end of the film, he's at like a after Hollywood party for one of his films. I think it was like a Fury. He's at the after party for a movie called Fury, okay? And he meets this guy, a guy named Jim Carrey, and Jim's like, Shia. Shia, they did it to me, they'll do it to you. You have to get out. You have to let everybody know that you're not gonna stand for this anymore. The Truman Show is true. I got out. You can too. And so Shia, thought he was weird before, but actually turns out he's completely normal, and everyone else is just acting normal, but they're all just as weird. Shia decides, you know what? I can't do this anymore. I want to make a film. And he makes a film. A film dedicated to himself and telling the world that he is not going to take it anymore. That he is not going to let his dreams be dreams. He is going to do it! Just do it with the Karate Triangle! Just do it! And he escaped from that TV show. He escaped from that TV show. There we go. That's my twist. Shia LaBeouf is actually in the Truman Show.
That was good.
I'm okay with that.
Is yours about Shia LaBeouf, Nolan?
No, it's
okay. I'm just going to say, I halfway through I was like, Shia LaBeouf is gonna have a slow downfall, and it's gonna end up, he's gonna grow up and be Gary Busey. That's where it was going. I thought that's where it was going. That'd be great.
I would have watched that movie.
That would have been great. But that was really good. I enjoyed that. That was great. Truman Show, good movie. Noah?
All right, so this film takes place in a fictional world. It's all one structure. All these creatures live in one structure, right? So it's like this really narrow, long, tall, kind of like Galway Hall, but a lot taller.
The
whole structure is made out of this like white, organic material. It's soft. It's weird, you know. So all the characters live inside this space on four sides. You know, there's like something. almost like an Earth. Like the Earth has a crust. It's kind of like a crust, but it's outside. So they're living their whole lives. You know, everything's going great.
I'm so confused.
And then one day the orange lights come. Right.
Everything is
just orange. Right.
Yeah,
and so they're freaking out. Things are starting to heat up, you know. It's a big struggle. So things are heating up. And slowly, their planet is dying very slowly. It's like, the white is fading into this like dark brown. It's fading. Eventually, it finally gets to black, and we're like, oh my god, like it's over. And then we cut out, and the toaster finishes, and out comes, and then our main character. Butters it, and the credits roll.
The Earth is a bagel. Oh my god.
Oh gosh.
I would watch that movie so hard. Look, even knowing the twist ending, I would still do it.
That was funny. That was good.
So, Tyler, because, I mean, you're not going from a list with, like, our last game. I feel like you should also go. And then we can let the commenters decide who likes the best on YouTube.
No, see, I
but that's the thing about us being on YouTube. Like, they can actually comment who they think is best.
Well, no, that's my job.
We just have Cody decide, you know?
Yeah. Cody, do you want to do one? Do you want to come?
No. You do one, and then Cody decides.
No, I think Tyler's fine. He's the host. He can't
come
do
on,
it.
Tyler.
Yeah, I don't know.
Yeah,
man.
Whatever.
Yeah, you're good, man.
You're looking really good today, by the way.
Thanks, man. Appreciate that, Felix.
You look very confident. You know, your beard's on point. Yeah.
Thanks, man.
You know, it'd be great if you like let me win this round. That'd be amazing, man.
Unless for bribery.
I thought you were being genuine, man.
No, I'm being Felix.
Let's see. I don't know. The Truman Show was great. Truman Show was great.
Don't say but.
And to be fair, I said I thought I saw it coming halfway through, but I really didn't. With yours, also very funny, very great. As soon as the orange lights came, I was like, I know exactly where this is going.
I really thought I had you.
Yeah. So.
And nothing to say about Brian's. Wow.
I mean, I already said.
I guess I'm staying in the zero zone.
Yeah, you're sitting pretty zero right now.
Maybe
so based
next episode.
Based purely on twist, I think yours was really good, Noah, and creative. But based purely on twist, which is what this is, I'm gonna have to give it to Felix.
Thank you.
I have to give
Thank
it to
you
Felix.
Very much.
Felix is winning so far.
Felix with 3, Noah with 2, Brian with 0. I'm very sorry. There's one more game later on that we will get to.
And I came up with it, so I feel pretty good.
Yeah. So there's only a couple more stuff that we're going to talk about, and I think mainly it's just some Marvel wrap-up stuff.
Okay.
So I got some news. The Hulk is not going to be in the Civil War movie. He was rumored that he was, and now he's not.
But the General is, which
the
is
general,
weird.
The General from the Incredible Hulk movie is, which is cool. And the other piece of news is Rachel McAdams has joined Doctor Strange.
Mitch Adams.
Apologize. Rachel McAdams is joining Doctor Strange. I don't think it said a.
No, she doesn't have a part yet.
A part yet. Yeah, but I love her.
Extra.
What's up?
She's an extra.
She's nurse number 3.
Mm-hmm. Oh, really?
In the one hospital scene.
Are they gonna get ScarJo for nurse number 2?
No, ScarJo's a Black Widow. Come on,
we're getting Natalie Portman.
Yeah, Natalie Portman.
I'd be okay with it.
So that's exciting. I love Doctor Strange. I can't wait for that movie to come out. And then the other thing was the Jessica Jones teaser trailer.
Ooh, yes.
That came out. Yes. No footage, but got me hype. And Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. comes back in a week.
They have been releasing pictures, though.
They did. They have released pictures.
Those
they released some promo pictures. David Tennant was in one of those pictures. He looks great. But of course, David Tennant is great. So, yeah, let's just throw out some thoughts on the MCU, Marvel Cinematic Universe as a whole. What do we think?
Well, like, for the Hulk, that's because they're making a Hulk trilogy that's going to end with Planet Hulk.
They are making a Hulk trilogy.
Yeah, so you know how we left the end... spoiler alert, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, Hulk left the end of Avengers 2 to go somewhere else. Mm-hmm. He's going to somehow end up going to Planet Hulk.
Interesting. I've heard rumors that is happening. I've heard that, no, they're not doing that. So
yeah, I've heard a lot of they're not doing that just because of rights wise.
I've heard they are and they aren't, so I don't know.
It seems like the rights for the Hulk character and all of his other friends are in kind of like weird limbo.
They're weird. Yeah.
Well, they're definitely doing a trilogy. We don't know if it's going to do Planet Hulk. But
gotcha.
They said they have a trilogy rights. So
interesting. Okay. Yeah, I'm glad he's not in it because whoever has Hulk is pretty OP.
Yeah.
On their Civil War team. However, Iron Man has Vision. Which I feel like is an automatic win because it's Vision, so that's kind of unfair.
And he wins in the comics?
I mean, that's true too. Yeah, he does. So.
They get him M. Night Shyamalan.
They should get M. Night Shyamalan. Maybe Vision's on working for Captain America the whole time. That's a twist. Doctor Strange, what are our thoughts on Doctor Strange, Rachel McAdams, who's Doctor Strange?
Benedict Cumberbatch is amazing.
That's been thrown around so much, though. It was going to be like Joaquin Phoenix.
I
that's been like the entire last year, like being like, oh yeah, this guy was going to be Doctor Strange. Oh, never mind.
Yeah.
They had I'm pretty sure every guy in Hollywood was rumored at some point to be
There was
Doctor
so
Strange.
Many casting rumors for that role. It was ridiculous.
Like, I think even for a short period of time, M. Night Shyamalan was actually going
to
be
Yeah, that was the twist. That was his twist. He's not directing, he's acting now. Yeah.
Well, yeah, after the visit, he's gonna have to do something besides directing, so.
Yeah, right? Jeez.
I'm actually gonna be talking about that Tuesday, it's on the corner at 5.
It's gonna, like, pretty.
This is the plug! What's everyone's. Let me try that question again.
That's okay. We can just start the show over.
Okay, yeah, let's start it.
Let's go again.
What upcoming Marvel movie is everyone most looking forward to?
Don't ask that question. That's a big question.
That is a big question.
I can tell you what my firstborn child is going to be named, but I can't tell you that.
Can you really? What is it going to be?
Yeah,
Brian.
Steven Spielberg Carlson.
Damn.
It's named after my uncle.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Oh, Steven Spielberg is your uncle.
No, my uncle's name is Dave.
Oh. Wait, what?
Made sense.
Okay.
Sure. I agree.
Cool.
Fantastic. Brian, what are you looking forward to?
I'm definitely looking forward to the eventual Captain Marvel movie,
mm-hmm.
because I want to see, because everyone's like, yeah, you know, we really want, like, a woman-centric movie, and Captain Marvel is the first one that's going to do that, you know, in the superhero genre, so I'm interested. Because
sure.
if Captain Marvel does well, then they're going to want to do more movies like that, so we might finally get our Black Widow movie.
Yeah, right.
So, I don't know. I'd be okay with it.
I'm excited for Civil War, because Civil War is, like, the second biggest thing that's ever happened in the Marvel Universe other than Secret Invasion.
Yeah.
Because that's, like, 3 years of like, so many authors writing comics. That's, like, a stack, like, this high, like, 3 feet high of comics. I have them all.
For those listening,
and they're all great.
Holding his hands about 2 feet apart from each other.
Yeah,
4 feet now.
It's a lot of comics, and it's a lot of narrative, and that's a lot to put into, like, 2.5 hours. And so they're not going to be able to put anything, and, like, I can't spoil it for you, but, like, there's a lot of things that are going to happen. A lot of people are going to die, and I don't know, like, how they're going to put all of that into 2.5 hours. It's going to be great, no matter what. I trust them. It's going to be amazing, but it's going to be weird.
Yeah.
Although, I would love it if they would actually me and Tyler actually had an argument about this on my show. I kind of want to see some concept art for Spider-Man.
No, I want to see nothing related to Spider-Man. I don't want to see Spider-Man referenced at all, zero. I want him treated like the Vision for Avengers, have his eyes maybe pop up for 1 second at the end of the trailer, and that is it. That's all I want to see. I don't want to see a single thing else regarding Spider-Man in this movie. At all.
But I want to see Spider-Man.
We're going to see him eventually.
I want to see him now. I have no patience for movies.
I think we should make a Spider-Man movie. I've never seen one.
There they are.
Yeah, right? Like,
yes.
Man.
Good job,
okay,
Spider-Man.
Yeah, I think Ashton Kutcher would make a great Spider-Man.
And let's see. What else?
No, it'd be better if we have Ashton Kutcher as Steve Jobs playing Spider-Man.
Ooh, Steve Jobs is Spider-Man?
In space.
Yeah.
In space.
There you go. There hasn't been a good Spider-Man movie since Steve
in
Jobs
space.
Died.
And he has a phone that Scarlett Johansson
right?
Steve
no,
Jobs
right?
Spider-Man.
Yeah.
Steve Jobs is Spider-Man.
And,
all
right.
We solved it.
And then it actually turns out to be a Truman Show, and he's not actually in space, he's just on set.
Jesus Christ. I'm most looking forward to Doctor Strange.
Yeah.
And Guardians of the Galaxy. Dos.
Oh my god.
It's actually called Volume 2.
Yeah, Volume 2, which is great.
After the disc that was found,
the disc,
not the disc, the cassette tape.
Just get out.
So, that's great.
I will throw my flip flop at you, and it will come on that screen when we're on YouTube, so it's going to be funny. And we're going to hear you yell on the radio show, so it's going to be funny anyway. Tell me to get out again.
Get out. By the way, this isn't a radio show.
Radio show.
By the way.
This is hawkstreamradio.org. This is a radio show.
It's actually just hawkstream.org.
Whatever.
Wait, aren't you like an officer?
Yes.
Oh.
Did I get the URL wrong? Whatever.
Okay.
I mean, hopefully they're already here. They made this far.
Go to hawkstream.org right now.
Yeah, multiple times.
Yeah, right? Alright, so does anyone have any other thoughts on the MCU? I mean, I know we could talk for like days about the MCU. Anyone can. Same with Star Wars, but does anyone have any other thoughts?
I think because we are at this place where Disney owns both, Star Wars MCU crossover?
Ooh.
That's what I want to see at some point.
That would be interesting.
Star Wars and MCU in Kingdom Hearts 3.
You can already do it in Disney Infinity 3.0 out now.
Okay.
Hey, Cody?
Let's plug.
We like Lego Dimensions here. We don't care about Disney Infinity or Skylanders.
Cool. Alright, so nothing else. No one, you have anything about the MCU?
I'm not really big into the superhero movies.
I used to be. I missed this. First off, camera's good?
Yeah.
Cool. I just checked sporadically. Spielberg had a quote recently. There will be a time when the superhero movie goes the way of the Western. True or not true?
Already false, because there are still Western movies that are being made. They're not as popular.
I think that's what he means. I mean, there'll still be superheroes made. They just won't be popular. The Western used to be the genre of film. Right now, the superhero is the genre of film. That's the money-making genre of film. There will come a time, he's saying, when the superhero movie goes the way of the Western, and that they lose quality and no one really cares about the superhero movie.
Like, I guess.
Because I think, like, each, like, era, like, has their own, like, movie that reflects the ideals. Like, Western was, like, people were starting to, like, settle down and not be as adventurous, so then people were like, oh, look back, this, like, frontiersman thing where everybody was, like, really strong, and then superhero, like, we're having a lot of trouble with, like, individuality and, like, tolerance in, like, today's society.
Also, we so all superheroes hate like now, so...
Yes. But superheroes, like, oh, yeah, look at these, like, humans who are more than humans that can do more than what they are today. So that's kind of, like, going with R&D.
Although I think it's going to be a while before it does happen. Sure, it will eventually happen because all films kind of, you know, fizzle out. But it's going to be a while. I'd say it's probably going to be at least another 100 years.
I think Civil War might do it.
Well, I mean,
Civil War's the end?
I think they're just building. They're going to keep building. And you can only build so high.
We're doing Infinity War. Infinity War Part 1 and 2.
That's what
directed by the Russo.
You mean Infinity War? Yeah.
Infinity War, then, like, Justice League. Once those two are done, I feel like it'll just, like...
That'll kind of be it. Everything,
like,
else will kind of be, like...
Everything else will be just, like, third act, just going down, tie loose ends, everybody's satisfied, and they're going, like, the next trend.
Yeah, I hate saying it, but I'm just, superhero movies are starting to get a little boring, you know, there's only, it's always feels very similar.
Yeah.
But now
we're having to reinvent these storylines every time, and I think it's starting to slow down.
Yeah.
But now that, like, we know that they know the formula's going to work, especially with Disney, since they have the resources to make whatever they want, now they're, like, trusting the directors to be more directorial about it. Like, with Avengers 1, that was, like, their first big one, so they didn't really let Joss Whedon do much other than, like, character work. But then they knew that it was going to work, so then with Guardians of the Galaxy, they just let
James Gunn.
James Gunn, I almost said Zack Snyder. James Gunn, like, do his movie the way he wanted to do it, and it was great.
Yeah.
So I feel like it's going to be more, like, not quirky per se.
They're going to start experimenting more with the superhero.
Yeah, they're going to be more films, less just processed MCUs.
Yeah. Let's go into our final game.
Yes.
We're getting ready to wrap up here. We're going to do a final game.
Woo-hoo.
We're going to go into some Flickr plugs. This final game is called... It doesn't have a funny name. It's called Movie Pickup Lines. So I'm going to throw a title of a movie out at you, and you have to give me a pickup line referencing that movie. So let's say, you could use... Let's say I say Wizard of Oz. You could say, I'll get you my pretty, I'll get you a fancy dinner, you know. So it could be, like, directly relating to a line in that movie, directly relating to the movie title. It could be super vague, the plot of the movie, something like that. It could be super vague. So are you guys ready? I'll give each of you, actually, you know, we'll do this. I'll throw out a movie. Each of you come up with a pickup line for that movie,
okay.
And then I'll pick a winner. We'll do, like, three rounds.
Okay,
sounds good.
Okay.
I'm
cool with it.
I'm confident in my abilities to fail to pick up women.
It might get a little inappropriate, so we'll see how this goes.
Yeah,
I'm gonna try to be the most appropriate.
That's why I waited until now to do it, because it's 9 o'clock, so the kids should be in bed by now.
Get the Marvin Gaye ready.
Yeah, get that. This is for the mature audiences, possibly. Let's see.
We could do little kid pickup lines.
We'll do that for the next one. We'll start with that.
Sorry, no, did you say you want to pick up little kids?
Yeah, like, you know.
Just do it!
Little kid pick up lines.
Yeah.
Okay,
what?
So let's think of a movie. Let's go with Ant-Man.
Okay. We can't use this one, though, right?
No, we cannot. You cannot use the one I used in the example that I sent you.
Okay.
Let's go with Ant-Man. Think of a pickup line relating to Ant-Man. Felix, I will start with you. I have not started with you yet.
Okay. Hey, yo, girl, let me put my little tiny suit on and I can fit into any hole.
Ooh!
Okay.
Ooh, okay. Like it. Noah, I'm heading to you.
I haven't seen Ant-Man yet. You're gonna have to give me a second.
Oh, I'll come back to you.
One based on the trailer, I guess.
Or just the name, something.
Hey, Brian. Girl, have you seen Ant-Man? Because I'm gonna show you my tank.
Oh, I get it. I get it. Because in Ant-Man, the tank grows. Okay, I get it.
Yes. Yeah, my dates after this episode are gonna go from 0 to -7. So, you know, why not? Let's do it.
Noah? Yeah.
Oh, man.
So he wears a tiny a suit that makes him really tiny. So
I know
just
there's the train scene,
little,
right?
Yeah.
So,
there's a train, yeah.
I want to play with the kids.
Wait!
What?
Wait!
Wait, which ones are we doing?
Wait!
What we're doing?
Are you trying to, like... Okay, this is to pick up girls, not for, like, the cops to pick you up and, like, take you to jail.
Oh, I thought we were doing the kid. Oh.
The kid one.
No,
the kid one's next time.
Next time?
Yeah.
Next time.
What?
Are you sticking with that one, though? That's all I got.
All right, stick with that one? All right.
I know the train scene.
Well, I don't want to get the cops on us. You had the tank. You had...
Hey, yo, girl, let me put on my little rubber suit.
I like that one.
Okay.
That one.
This is my game and I'm losing.
Ow. But by the way, my rubber suit is actually fairly large. So you know, I have a girlfriend, by the way, but just need to put that out there so my rep isn't that I have a
rubber suit. Let's think of another one. I have a bunch of movies up here. Let's see. Let's go.
Back to the Future?
What's up?
Back to the Future?
No.
I got a good one for that one.
Let's go.
Where we're going, we don't need roads.
Wow. Wow.
Can you stop?
Can you explain?
Let's see. Interstellar. Interstellar pickup line. I'll start with Brian this time.
Okay. Let's see. So, Hey girl, I like that butt because it's interstellar. I don't know.
Okay. Noah? Interstellar?
I've got the basis, you know?
It's just space.
Yeah, space. I want to dock near black hole, I guess. It's a wormhole, right?
Yeah.
Right. I want to dock in your wormhole.
Appreciate that one.
I'm so done with this episode.
That was very sensual in my ear. Felix, wrap it up.
I'm going to use a potty word.
I can bleep it out.
Hey, yo, girl. It ain't just gonna be your mind, I'm gonna in four dimensions.
Oh,
okay,
I
feel like he's kicking her
with his mind. Okay. I think we'll get that one to Noah, honestly. I think Noah got a good one there.
Alright,
that was good.
It's fine.
Brian's still at zero.
It's nothing against you, Brian. You're just not performing well.
It's okay.
Yeah.
Wow.
Let's go with final movie, final pick of line, Birdman. I'll start with you, Noah, this time.
Just give me one shot.
I was gonna say that! No! That was great. Felix?
Oh my. No! can we go to Brian for a second, please?
Alright, Brian.
I'll show you a good performance.
Okay.
Oh,
Felix?
Gosh.
It's up to you.
Oh gosh. I can keep going for 2 hours.
Wow, that's good too.
All, it's about ego. It's also about pleasuring you, but mostly ego.
Oh,
hey,
man.
Let me blow your brains out.
Oh, does he? That's right, he shoots himself. That's right.
Man.
And he misses.
Yeah. Hey, yo, girl.
Or does he?
Ever seen Edward Norton's butt?
That's a good one too. I'm going to have to go with Felix on that one. That was a good one. I can go on for 2 hours. I enjoyed that.
Thank you very much.
That made me giggle. One shot, very close second. That was fun.
That was
and
really
Brian
good.
Brian will always be in third.
Brian, I'm sorry. You end with 0 points. So, the
just
final
like
tally.
Brian's the Leonardo DiCaprio.
Yeah, Brian, you're Leo. Just say
yes!
There you go. So, Brian with 0, Noah with 3, and Felix with 5. Points.
Don't worry, I'll come back.
These points will be added throughout the year, throughout every podcast.
Wow.
And we'll keep a running tally.
Do we have like Double Jeopardy or anything?
at some future possible. Right. Yeah.
I'm just going to be a guest as often as possible.
Yeah, we're just
going to keep
going. Okay, so I think we ran through a bunch of news. Mm-hmm. We played some games. We had some fun. How'd you guys like this podcast? You guys have a good time?
I had fun.
I liked it.
Did the audience have fun? Did you guys have fun watching,
did
listening?
You have fun?
This is hopefully I get maybe my mom will text me. Hey, good job, son. Okay, so let's wrap it up. A couple Flickr notes.
Then we gotta sing the outro song.
I'll start us off.
Don't worry,
yeah. So couple Flickr notes. There was a Flickr meeting, YouTube meeting, and Realtor meeting this week. Mm-hmm. You should come to all of them.
If Deloach 114?
139? Well, Deloach 1... No. Yes, that's right. The Flickr meeting tomorrow, Monday, mm-hmm. September 21st, is in Deloach 114.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Usually we're in Morton 100. That is not the case tomorrow. So if you're listening, if you're interested in Flickr, it is in Deloach 114 tomorrow. But Realteal and YouTube meetings are same time, same place, Lucy 139, 8 p.m. for YouTube, 7 p.m. on Wednesday for Realteal.
And we're having a video race tomorrow.
So that's right.
You definitely want to come out to the
meeting. For trailers or something, right?
Yes.
Yeah.
It's going to be a lot of fun.
Yeah.
What's that?
We're having a 48-minute trailer video race.
Yes, that's a... Yeah, this is...
Oh, you have 40 minutes to, like, film one?
48 minutes.
Yeah.
Oh.
Yeah, we'll talk about it a lot more tomorrow.
Don't worry.
It's going to be very exciting.
It's definitely doable.
So definitely come out to that meeting tomorrow. It's going to be a little contest.
Okay.
A lot of other fun, exciting stuff in the works. And shout out to the two productions going on right now, Deadbeat by Carson Rochow and Shipman by Adam Falkman.
Which might be wrapped by now.
It's late. Yeah, I think they were supposed to wrap around 10.
Okay.
So
good luck, you guys.
Yeah, hope they're doing good. So
probably not listening to us, but you know, it's fine.
Yeah, it's
you're
fine.
On set.
Anything else?
Oh man, we're so screwed. Let's just listen to Flickr. We have to.
Yeah, right. Like, oh crap. Anything else, guys? Do we have anything else we want to say?
The Corner Tuesdays at 5 this week with
That's
my
right,
friend
right.
Olivia Newton. We're going to be talking about horror movies. We're going to be talking about The Visit by M. Night Shyamalan.
That's right.
Babadook, which I actually met the director at Sundance. And you guys were talking about Nymphomaniac.
Yes.
Earlier in the episode. I was actually going to get to see that at Sundance because it was like the mystery film, but I didn't get in.
You went to Sundance?
Yeah.
Two years ago.
Interesting.
Wow. Very cool.
I don't know, I want to go back at some point, but I'm too busy.
Awesome.
And it's expensive.
Cody, do you want to come over here and plug your show real quick? Come over here, Cody.
Follow me on
there he is. Get on camera.
Yeah.
Get the mini mic. Get the mini mic right here. Right here, buddy. Right here. There you go.
Okay. Well, there's my show, Canon Ex Machina, Thursdays at 6:30 here on Hawkstream.
Fantastic. All right, so plug everyone's shows, plug some Flickr stuff.
Well, I think we should definitely say thank you to Hawkstream for letting them use their equipment, their website, and just that we're working together with them, because
usually a lot
of campuses on clubs on campus don't work together, so it's kind of nice that we have a
partnership. Yes. Shout out to Hawkstream. If you want to get to the website, if you're watching this on YouTube, there'll be a link in the description down below. There'll also be a link to the description, and once YouTube, if you're watching on YouTube, a link in the description down below of literally every story we talked about, every trailer.
Nice.
You'll find a link down below. So that's the benefit of watching it on YouTube as well.
All the links. All of the links.
Shout out to Hawkstream. Shout out to Flickr. Shout out to Shia LaBeouf and Garrett Busey. I think we're good to go.
Shout out to M. Night.
We gotta sing the song.
Shout out to M. Night.
Ready?
Oh, right.
I'm gonna start with the song.
Okay. Right,
so
that's right.
The outro to bring us out.
Right, okay.
I'm the computer.
Oh, right, okay.
Alright.
Here we are to flick our flickers. Here we are to do a podcast.
Flick, flicker, flick, flick, flicker, flick.
Flicker, flick, flick, oh, flicker, flick, flicker, flick, flick, a flicker, flick, flicker, flick, flick, a flicker, flick, yeah!
Ooh, cut.
Beautiful. Woo. All right. Brian, how do I do this? How do I turn this off?
It's line in.
Line in.
You can't turn off the
music. Auto on.
The music lives.
Auto off.
Auto off?
Flick, flick. And then it will just keep playing.
Okay. Can they still hear us though?
Nope.